Automated flow chemistry. It takes minutes to automate flow reactors, not months. Hello, my name is Thomas Kretschmer, and today I'm going to show you how easy it is to automate a flow chemistry setup. In this case, we're going to automate a demo setup where you have two food colorings which are running through this AirFed microreactor system and measure the color at the output. Here you can see the AirFed setup in more detail. In the middle, we have the Lonza flow plate reactor. We can also directly see the fluids running through. We have a temperature sensor and a pressure sensor, as well as the inlets and outlets for the liquids. At the outlet, we then measure the current Keller value of the liquid running through. This is, of course, a demo setup. However, this could be just as well a more complicated setup or used for chemical synthesis. And you could also, instead of the color sensor, use a different analysis device, such as a spectrometer or liquid chromatography. We are now in the LabVision software, where we can create our user interface for our microreactor. What you can see here is a flowchart of our setup, where we have two dosing pumps on the left, which pump our liquids with the food coloring through our microreactor in the middle right here. We want to measure the temperature, the pressure, as well as sense the color value at the output. As you can see here, we already have a flowchart, which we can now use to simplify and aid us in creating a user interface. So I'm going to go and modify, because now I can add additional visualization modules. And what you can see here on the right-hand side are the libraries we can use for our visualization. As you can see here, HiTechSung already has a library for all the different AirFed modules. And to start off, I'm going to select the flowplate reactor, which can be found here as flowplate lab. And since this is just a visualization, we don't need to add any data points or device drivers here, and can just accept. Okay, now I'm going to line it up to the inlets and outlets. That's where the existing flowchart helps us in the visualization. And now what we still need to add connectors for, again, just for visualization, as well as a temperature and pressure sensor. So starting off with the sensors, we have the temperature sensor module right here. And the temperature is measured at the inlet for the second pump. Now I'm going to also add the pressure sensor module, and we are measuring the pressure at the reactor outlet. Now we can add additional connectors. Those are really just for visualization. And I can copy this connector. And one more time for the outlet. All right, so let's switch back to the finished user interface. As you can see here, there's still data missing for the temperature and pressure. Here we're going to add data points later. For now, let's focus on the two pumps for which we still need the visualization and the control, and then the communication between the LabBox automation unit and the pumps themselves. HiTechSung offers project modules, which makes such an integration rather easy. So I switched over to project modules. I'm going to select a new instance. And here you see a large library of all the different available project modules. In this case, I'm going to select a syringe dosing pump. And here we can just go on continue. And all the different parts of project modules, including device drivers, control programs, and so forth, are created. And now we have our project module for this one syringe pump, which we can also now find as a device driver under device components. Here we can also see where this pump is supposed to be connected in our automation unit. Now I'm going to add the second Zirdos pump as well. This is basically the same as I did with the first pump. And now we also have that project module. As you can now see under device drivers, a different connector was also assigned to this pump now. If we now are on the measuring setup and we want to add additional visualization, we now have under the project modules two visualizations of our pumps, which I can now add to our interface.
All right, so what is still missing are now the data points for the temperature and pressure. And I have already created those under the data points, since each sensor needs to have specific parameters that we then use to identify the sensor. Now I'm going to set those up again in the designer for our interface by clicking on the temperature module and selecting our temperature sensor. We do now the same here for the pressure sensor. First of all, here we have the pressure that we want to measure, as well as a maximum value we can set, which is then displayed down here. Okay, so now we also have added the two sensors, and as you can see, we already see the temperature and pressure value. What's still missing is now the color sensor. The color sensor is connected via RS232, and as such, we have a device driver for that component, whereas numerical data points are both used for variables and digital and analog signals. Now, Hightech Sung already offers a large library of different components, which I can show you when I create a new device driver. However, in this case, the color sensor is a device that was connected the first time for this project. In that case, you can create new device drivers yourself, or Hightech Sung can create new device drivers for you, which can then be imported via user templates. In this case, I already imported this new device driver via this button right here. This can now be found under user-defined devices, and now I can select our color sensor. All right, and now I go back to our designer. Since we now want to see the color value, I am going to add a numerical display, for which I can now select one of the outputs of the color sensor, in which case we are getting back one of the color values. And under properties, I also can now select which the label that's supposed to be displayed, so we can see what we are measuring right here. Let's make that a bit bigger. And now we can switch back to our user interface. And as you can see now, we can set the flow rates and turn on and off both pumps. We see the current flow rates. We get an alarm if we have problems with the communication. We have the temperature and pressure sensors, as well as the sensor for the color values, which gives us already a full control of our reactor setup. This is now a more detailed setup of our project. First of all, you still have the basic controls we created before, where we have two syringe pumps, where we control the flow rate and turn on and off the pumps. We have the visualization of our flow plate reactor. We measure the temperature and pressure, and also the color value of the color sensor. In this case, I've created a more detailed panel of our color sensor. We can see all three color values, as well as set a white reference for the color sensor. On the right-hand side, we now have additional controls for a PID control.
First of all, on the right-hand side, we have our control panel of our PID controllers, where you can adjust the different parameters of your controller, as well as see the current status and the current set point. In this panel, I created additional functions. First of all, you can also set the set point here, but we also can see here the range of possible color values with the current food coloring for the liquids we are using. And we can also set a pulse length for a square wave signal. To create these values as well as set up the square wave, we have here additional Hightech programs. And here we have additional control panels for the Xeros pump. Since now we have the case where we can control the Xeros pumps manually as well as by the PID controller, I have here a panel where you can switch between those two control modes. And as well then, if it's manual mode, set a flow rate and turn on and off the pump. Now to illustrate the Hightech programs, I'm going to switch over to Hightech, which is Hightech Sung's programming language for an easy creation of specific control programs and controllers. And in this case, I'm going to show you the program I wrote to determine the range of the color values. It's a rather simple setup where we first of all enable both pumps, then set the flow rate of one pump to the maximum, wait 30 seconds, and then determine the current color value, which is then saved in this data point, which is also then shown in the panel. Then we switch over to the other pump, again with the maximum flow rate. and wait 30 seconds to flood the whole reactor, measure again the color value, and then set both pumps to a flow rate of 0. And finally, it will show you in a separate pop-up window the two values determined for the possible color range. This has already been done in this case, as you can see here for those two numbers. So now, to illustrate our plot functions as well as the PID controller, I'm going to turn on both pumps. And now you can see here that they are both set to PID control. I'm going to turn on the PID controller, as well as start the square wave program, which will create a square wave, which changes the set point for the PID controllers between those two values. Now I'm going to switch over to the plotter, where you can then see the current set point, the current color value, as well as the control signal of the PID controller. And as you can see here, the set point now changed according to the square wave function, which also means that the PID control response or set point for the syringe pumps changed. Now you can see here that also the color value adjusted accordingly, dropping to the low value. And here we have now a change back to the high value of the set point, which also results in a change again in the control signal. And now we have again an increase also in the actual color value. And now this will continue to switch back and forth according to that square signal. So overall, we now have a setup where we can adjust flow rates directly, see the temperature and pressure, see in this case a value from a color sensor in your device that might be a spectrometer or other analysis system, and also can set up a PID control circuit, as well as additional control programs, which gives you a lot of freedom for your specific application.